מסכת מנחות, page 8. We'll start on page 7b, three lines from the bottom of the page. In Judaism, the idea of study consecutively, not in pieces, is not only crucial, it's very important. It's a well-known story in the Talmud that many of you are familiar, the life of the Tanar, the Rabbi Akiva. He was sent by his wife to study for 12 years, and upon coming back and hearing her talking to a neighbor without his knowledge, he heard that she said she wished him to be there another 12 years, meant to say she really supported the idea of him study, and he went back and he studies. And the famous Mashgiach of Chaim Shmuelevitz, may he rest in peace, asked that famous question, how come he didn't come home, knock the door, spend the time, just went back and study another 12 years? And he said, having the study consecutively as a full unit is the message here. Making something with cutting with pieces makes a big difference. So here we are, in a way something similar that we studied yesterday, what Rav Zrika said on behalf of Rabbi Lazar, that Dam Zevach cannot be sanctified Lachatzaim, which means when you don't have in one vessel Meloshi'u. So the Gemara asks, since we talk about the whole issue of a sanctification of blood collected in two vessels, Umi Amar Rabbi Lazar Hachi, is that something that Rabbi Lazar really said, that the blood is sanctified only when it's a full measure, is initially collected in a single vessel? Ve'itmar chavitei kohen gadol, but we learn in regard to kohen gadol chavitei, which is a griddle cake offering, Rabbi Yochanan amar eina kedusha lachatzaim. Rabbi Yochanan said it's not sanctified in a half, which is if half of a tenth of the eifa was placed in one vessel and the second half in another vessel, so the neither is sanctified. Rabbi Lazar amar mitoch shekreiva lachatzaim kedusha lachatzaim. Rabbi Lazar said because and since it's sanctified in halves, which is you have here half of a meal offering is sacrificed in the morning and another half in the afternoon, it may sanctify in half because the Torah did not require to have it all together. So that's the reason why he hold that way. Page 8. V'im ita leilaf midam. If it's going so that Rabbi Lazar holds that the blood may not be sanctified in halves, so he can derive the halachot of Kohen Gadol griddle cake offering from that of blood. Tosfot challenged that. You see also in Taharat HaKodesh and Rashba. V'chita im Rabbi Lazar milta bimilta lo gamar. You tell me, it may happen that Rabbi Lazar does not derive the halacha of the matter of a meal offering from another matter that is difficult. Ve'amar Rabbi Lazar mincha shekimtza ba'echal. Rabbi Lazar hold that if you have a meal offering from which the Kohen remove a handful while inside the sanctuary, so he said, k'shera, it's valid. Even that the handful should be removed from the in the temple courtyard. Why? The reason is she can matzinu besiluk bazichin, because you have a very similar case when it's come to a sanctuary, when it's come to removal of the balls of the levona from the table of the shubred. Same way as the bowl permit the shubred for consumption when removed in the sanctuary, so the same way as the handful permits the remainder of the meal offering for consumption. So it means that Rabbi Lazar does drive the halacha of a meal offering from that of another matter. So the Gemara said, b'mincha, b'mincha, mincha, mincha, yalif. Mincha midam, lo yalif. Rabbi Lazar does derive the halacha with regard to meal offering from that what another meal offering. The shoe bird is considered a meal offering, but it does not derive the halacha with regard to meal offering from that of blood. So the Gemara asks, "Mimincha mi alef?" והתניה עד שלא פירקה נפרס לחמה. ולאם לברייטה, if before the Kohen detach the arrangement of shoe bread and the ball of the levona from upon the table, the bread broke in two pieces. The bread is unfit for consumption and the Kohen does not burn the levona contained in a ball on account of it. הלחם פסול ומקטיר עליו את הבזיחין, משפרקה, if the bread broke after the Kohen detached it, משפרקה נפרס לחמה, הלחם פסול ומקטיר עליו את הבזיחין. The bread is unfit, but the Kohen burns the levona contained the ball on the account of it. ואמר רבי אלעזר, לא פרקה ממש. אלעזר said that the braita here referred to the detachment of the shoe bird does not mean that the Kohen actually detached it. אלא כיוון שהגיע זמנה לפרק, when once the time to detach it's arrived, אף על פי שלא פרקה, even though he has not yet detached it and has not removed the balls, כמי שפרקה דמיה, it's considered as though he has detached it. So what you see here, if the shoe bread broke after that time, the lefona is burned. So the Gemara explained the question. Ve'amai, and if you tell me that Rabbi Lazar derives the halakha of a meal offering from another, why does he say that the levona contained in the bowl are burned in a case where the shoe bread broke when the time to detach the bread had arrived? Tehevek kemincha shechasra kodem kmitza. So you should treat it like of a meal offering that become lacking in its measure before the removal of the handful. So you have a handful is not removed and is not sanctified upon the altar. So the same way as the levona was still on the table when the shoe bread broke and should therefore be disqualified. So the Gemara said, Halokashia, mincha lo brir, breira kometz didei. It's not the issue, why? Because when it's come to a meal offering that become lacking because of the removal of a handful, its handful was not clearly designated. So what you see here, if the meal offering become lacking before a handful was removed, one may no longer remove a handful from it. But in the case of a shoe bread and the ball of levona, its handful, which is the levona, והבריר, ברירה קומץ דידה, וכיוון שהגיע הזמנה לפרק, כמן דפרקה דמיה. So when it's time to detach the bread had arrived, it's considered as though it has detached it. So the Gemara asks, if that's the case, אלא מעתה, תהבה כשיריים שחסרו בין קמיצה להקטרה. So you should treat it like a reminder of the meal offering, become lacking between the removal of the handful and the burning upon the altar. And the halacha is, then maktirin komets alem. So they does not burn the handful on the account of such a meal offering. Simon said, lav plugtan in you? It wasn't that the disputation between the Tanaim on page 9, whether or not a handful is burned in such a case. Rabbi Lazar savar lakeman de amar shirayim shechasru ben kmitza lakzara maktir komets alem. Rabbi Lazar hold the same as man de omo, that said that the reminder of the meal offering become lacking between the removal of the handful and the burning, the Kohen burns the handful on account of such a meal offering. So Gemara continues and said, Chavita, Gufa, Chavitei Kohen Gadol. So we have here a griddle cake offering of the Kohen Gadol. Rabbi Yochanan Amar, Rena Kedusha Lachatzaim. Rabbi Yochanan said, it's not sanctified in half. ורבי לזר אמר, מתוך שקריבה לחצאין, קדושה לחצאין, because it's sanctified in half, as half of the meal offering is sacrificed in the morning and half in the afternoon, the same way is sanctified in half. אמר רבי יחם, הייתה מדי רבי יוחנן, או רבי יוחנן said that it's not. אמר קרא, מנחה מחציתה, the pasuk said in Leviticus chapter 6, a meal offering, half of this in the morning and half in the evening. Have mincha, ואחר כך חוצרו. First, bring a whole meal offering. And only afterward, you divided it into a half. מיתי ורחביתי כהן גדול לא היו באות חצאין, אלא במין יסרון שלם וחוסרו. The griddle cake of the Kohen Gadol not come in a half. Rather, the Kohen Gadol bring a full tenth of Eifa, and then divided it into two. ותניה נאמר מנחת מחצית, מנחה מחצית, הייתי אומר, מביא חצי יסרון מביתו שחרית ומקריב, חצי יסרון מביתו ערבית ומקריב. So you should bring half and a half bring the offering. תלמוד לומר מחציתה בבוקר, half of it in the morning. So you derive from that, מחצה משלם ומביא. That he brings a half from a whole and does not bring a half by itself. So the Gemara responds, here the Rabbi Lazar holds that this pasuk requires the whole meal offering be brought in the morning only למצווה, לחתחילה, למצווה. אמר לרב גביה מבאר קטיל לרב אשי והחוקה כתיב בי, it's written statute. אמר לו, אני צריכה להביא השלם מביתו, I need to bring the full tenth from his house. So when he have the sanctification in the service vessel, it can be sanctified in halves. וגמרי אסק, מי אמר רבי יוחנן, הכי, is that true? רבי יוחנן סדל והיתמר, הפריש חצי יסרון ודעתו להוסיף. We learn if one set aside a half of tenth of Eifa for any meal and offering, and his intention was to add half in order to reach the full tenth. רב אמר אינו קדוש, רבי יוחנן אמר קדוש. ואם איתה לילה אף מחוויתים, if you derive it from griddle cake offering, that no meal offering may be sanctified in halves, וחיתה אמר רבי יוחנן מילתא מילתא לא שיאלי, ואמר רבי יוחנן, שלמים ששחטן בהיכל, you have a meal, a peace offering, that was sanctified in a sanctuary, so he said, כשרים, they are valid. תכתיבו שחטו פתח אוהל מועד, אסן לביטיקוס צ'פטר 3, the slaughter, the entrance of the town of meeting, which is in the courtyard, שלא יהיה תפל חמור מעיקר, which we understand it logically, that the הלכה, when it's come to the courtyard, which is a minor area, should not be more stringent than the halacha with regard to major area, which is the tent of meeting. So you see here, Rabbi Yochanan hold the halacha when it's come to the sanctuary from the temple courtyard. So more response, Rabbi Yochanan does in fact drive the halacha on one matter from another. And therefore we learn the halacha with regard to all meal offerings from a griddle cake offering that is in general, they are not sanctified in halves. דעתו להוסיף שני, when it's intention to add to a half measure is different. נתן הם מלאים הם מלאים מלשלמים. כלומר, see here the Gemara use the word כלומר, right? It means שאינו קדוש עד שיהיה יסרון שלם. It's not full until it's it's a full tenth inside the vessel. אמר רבי יוסי מתי, רבי יוסי, when is the הלכה? בזמן שאין דעתו להוסיף, אבל בזמן שדעתו להוסיף, but time when his intention was initially to add, ראשון, ראשון קדוש, each initial bit of flour is sanctified by the vessel. ורב בחביתין כמן סביר עלי, איקרא בלעזר ללחם מחביתין. So the רב הלכה from the griddle cake, offering that all meal offering may be sanctified in halves. חיתה עם הרב ממילתא, מילתא מילתא לא יאליף, ואמר רב מנחה קדושה בלא שמן, סמסד ובלא לבונה, שכן מצינו בלחם הפנים, מצאנו in a shoe bread, which is sanctified without oil, and nevertheless sanctified by a service vessel. So the same way, here, בלא לבונה, שכן מצינו מנחת נסחים, that even without לבונה, because you find הלכה with regard to a meal offering, accompany a libation of an offering. which is sanctified without levona, and nevertheless sanctified by a service vessel. So the Gemara said, "Below shemen below levona, without both oil and levona, sheken matzinu minchat chotei, we send the meal offering of a sinner, which include neither one of these." Al kochech rav k'rabbi Yochanan svir alei. You hold that this offering is not sanctified in halves, and derived from there, there is no meal offering or sanctified in halves. גוף המערב, מנחה קדושה בלא שמן. Meal offering that is sanctified without its oil. ואין דינה כי יסרון חסר, שכן מצינו בלחם בפנים בלא לבונה, שכן מצינו במנחת נסכים בלא שמן בלא לבונה, שכן מצינו במנחת חוטא. And Rav continues, ושמן ולבונה קדשי היי בלא היי והי בלא היי, שמן שכן מצינו בלא שמן של מצורה, לבונה שכן מצינו בלבונה באה ובזיכין. ורבי חנינה אמר, Page A, B, לא זו קדושה בלא זו, ולא זו קדושה בלא זו. Neither one is this substance sanctified without that, nor that sanctified without this. So it means that any meal offering that requires oil and levona is sanctified by a service vessel only when the flour, oil, and levona are all placed in the same vessel at the same time. ולרבי חנינה, יסרון למה נמשך? According to רבי חנינה, what's the purpose that you have a tenth of an eifa anointed, making it possible for it to sanctify item into a place inside it? ועלו אנו עשו אלא מדידת קמח בלבד, the only purpose is to measure flour. והקמח אינו קדוש בלא שמן. Flour is not sanctified without oil. So they said למנחת חוטף, or meal offering of a sinner, which contain neither oil nor לבונה. ולוג למה נמשך? ללוג של מצורה, for a leper. Which is not brought as part of a meal offering, this oil sanctified without flour or levona. נגמר נוט, ואף שמואל סבר להדרב, דתנן כלי הלך מקדשין את הלך, ומידות היבש מקדשין את היבש, ואין כלי הלך מקדשין את היבש, ולא מידות היבש מקדשין את הלך. ואמר שמואל לא שנו אלא מידות, it's measures. אבל מזרקות, but balls that are used for collecting and tossing the blood של דם, מקדשות את היבש, שנאמר שניהם אלה עם סולת בולה בשמן למנחה. אומר לרבה חמיד, יפתי לרבינה, מנחה לחה היא. אומר ללא נצריכה ליבש שבה, דהיינו לבונה. ויסר כדעתך, כסבר שמואל, אין מנחה קדושה עד שיהיו כולן יבש שבה, היכם השכחת לה, ולא כולן לחים מהן, מפני השמן. אלא שמה מנה כסבר שמואל, היי ולא היי. ויבייתם, המנחה לגבי דם, כי יבש דמיה. גוף אמר רבי לזר, מנחה שקמצה בהיכל כשרה, שכן מצינו בסילוק בזיכין. מטיב רבי ירמיה וקמץ משם ממקום שרגלי הזר עומדות, which is anywhere in the temple courtyard. בן בטרה אומר, מניין שאם קמץ בשמאל שיחזיר ויקמוץ בימין, תלמוד לומר, וקמץ משם ממקום שקמץ כבר. איקא דאמרי הוא מוטיב לה והוא מפרק לה. איקא דאמרי אמר לרבי יעקב לרבי ירמיה בר תחליפה אסבר הלך. לא נצריכה אלא להכשיר את כל הזרה כולה. שלא תאמר הואיל ועולה קודשי קודשים מנחה קודשי קודשים. מה עולה תאונת צפון? אף מנחה תאונת צפון. מה לא עולה שכן כליל? מחטאת. מה לחטאת שכן מכפרת על חי וכריתות? מהאשם. מה לאשם שכן מיני דמים? מכול עונה מי שכן מיני דמים. אלא יצריך סגל התחה מן העול לכתיב וכתיב יקרבה אל הכהן וגישה למזבח וקמץ. מה ההגשה בקרן דרומית מערבית? אף קמיצה בקרן דרומית מערבית. סדר פור קמש מלאה.